How do you want to store your PSA or BGS graded cards? Welcome to the Solemn Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel, where we discuss everything collecting and investing in Yu-Gi-Oh! Today we are talking storage. Now, the other day we already spoke about this awful story where people's cards were stolen. And so we already talked about putting your cards in the bank, about the viability or non-viability of having your own safe, and all of that. Now we're gonna go even deeper than that. Let's say you do put cards in a bank, or you do put cards in some safe, or anything like that. How do you then want to store your cards beyond that? Now obviously, there's 1,000 ways, so obviously we won't be going over all of them. I'm just gonna tell you some things that I personally like to do. Now first of all, if your collection isn't very big or worth all that much, maybe this doesn't matter. You know, if your collection is worth under $1,000, it's probably not worth taking out a bank vault for $100 or buying special cases for $100 or $200, when that's like, that's more then your collection will grow reliably over time. That's just the truth. However, if you are entering that slightly higher level of collection, maybe this might be interesting to you. So one of the things I'm a fan of is these Pelican cases. Now, this is a small one because it's easier to show you like this. There's also bigger ones, and so depending on your needs, you might want a bigger one. Now, be aware, Pelican is a very trusted, great brand. They have lifetime warranty as well. They are basically industry standard when it comes to this type of case. Like if you go to the film industry or the music industry with very special microphones or very special lenses, very often you will find Pelican cases, and then the inside, the foam, will be rigged so that those are essentially held not only safe, but also safe from other things. So it's not just about the falling, it's also about, for example, humidity. So here you have this valve, for example, and that's trying to equalize pressure in and outside. This way, the inside doesn't get overly humid as it gets colder outside, or air pressure changes because of that cold, and that way you get like little water droplets actually. There's actually a major issue inside something like a fireproof vault. So there's people out there who say like, oh, I just put all my cards at home in vaults and that'll be fine. Well, those vaults actually have pressure issues. Well, they're not made to store trading cards. No one's making trading card vaults. Well, are they? Maybe they are, but in general they don't. And so it's very easy for your cards to turn into Pringles, because even inside the PSA slab, the humidity can just go up, oh, hello, and your card's fucked. That's also why very often you see these PSA slabs being sold, or well, cards inside PSA slab, and the little PSA paper is all wrinkled up. When you see that, be aware, it's very possible that the card has some humidity damage already. It's also possible it's just a PSA paper, so don't just start judging from there, but be aware. So that's why one of these is good. Now, I'm not telling you that this will automatically completely protect you from that and that you should go swimming with them, obviously, but it's better to have something like that than to not have it. Now, there are cheaper cases out there. I personally, like, when you enter the territory of higher end cards, are you really gonna skimp $30 on your expensive cards? I'm sure there's great brands out there. Go look for them if you're interested in that. If you want to min max that, I'm not gonna stop you. I just like this one. I also have a link in the description with product recommendations where you can buy this one and also bigger ones and so forth. So this size obviously isn't for a whole collection. What I like about this size is that it fits into your typical bank safety deposit box, or at least, well, mine. Sure, your bank may do the best they can to have the humidity and temperature all checked out, but if you're still uncertain about that, you know, this is just an extra layer, and I like that. So I don't know if you've actually ever seen these before. I'll quickly open it up. You have your two thingies, and you open, and then boom, we have it right here. I think there's room for 6, maybe 7 cards in here, so this is definitely not for entire collections. This is just for maybe a few key cards. The Revival Gem is just an example. Obviously, that's not a big hitter or anything like that. You get these completely filled with foam, and then you can basically cut out the stuff you don't need to make it fit whatever you want. That's also why you have bigger ones, and you will often see people put their sealed boxes in there as well. They'll cut out the exact size they need, put the box in there, and then also make room for their cards that way. And so you notice it's very tidy, very cozy. You can close it up again, close it again. And I just feel slightly more safe with these. Again, link will be in the description where you can check out these as well as bigger ones. I think I've listed like this size, which is the small size for like a few key cards, let's say. You put them in your bank's vault or in a safety deposit or another company. Doesn't even matter what you do. There's also a bigger one. I feel like that's very good to go to trade shows or maybe making a deal if you go out there and make a deal with someone in real life. And then there's one even bigger size. That's where you're like, okay, fine. This doesn't fit in anything. This is just you're going to a card show or you are gonna sell a big collection or anything like that. But so yeah, I mean, once you have like a few cards that are worth many thousands, you're not putting them in a cardboard box, right? You want a level of safety, I feel. But I can't promise you that your cards are perfectly safe just because you put them in some kind of box. I'm just saying, that's what I like, that's what I feel safe with. But do always do your own research and figure things out. Seriously, the last thing you want is for your cards to become Pringles. Like, you spend a lot of money on them and you think, okay, I'll just sit on these for a long time, they'll gradually go up over time, and after a while you check them out and you go, oops, they're all worthless now. That's a really shitty feeling. That is not something you want. So you're looking for a place that's temperature stays the same, humidity stays the same. Quite some fireproof vaults are not that. So you may want to either put them inside something like that and then inside that, but that's even still a bit risky. You're mostly looking for a place that does this stuff for you. This one will be going back to the bank. Just be sure to take care of your stuff. And the higher value it gets, the more careful you really have to be, because the risk just exists, you know? That is all. Hope you found this interesting. Like, subscribe, and I will see you soon. Ciao.